Hi folks, in today's video, I'm continuing my series on grounding. In my last video, I explained what a ground is and listed their many types. The links at the end of this video. Today, I'll discuss electrostatic discharge, or ESD. The human is capacitively grounded, which means you charge up as you move around. Your shoes shuffling along the carpet or your clothes brushing against your skin can create an electrostatic charge. It's very easy to end up with 20 to 25,000 volts of charge. The most common circuit model of the human body consists of a 150 picofarad capacitor in series with a current limiting resistor of 330 ohms. With 25,000 volts of charge, the current through that 330 ohm resistor to ground has a peak value of over 75 amps. When you touch an electronic device that does not provide a discharge path for this current, it will most likely be damaged. It typically takes an ESD discharge of between 2,500 and 3,500 volts for a person to feel the shock. However, even a small discharge of only 25 volts can damage electronic components, and you won't feel a thing. Damage from ESD events can be cumulative. It need not be outright destructive. If this damage goes undetected, the lifespan of the device can be shortened, resulting in premature failure. To protect against this during manufacture, conductive wax is used on grounded factory floors, and each operator wears a grounding heel strap. This heel strap has a conductive ankle strap, which is placed inside one sock and has a high-value resistor in series between the conductive ankle strap and the strap around the heel of the shoe, which completes the circuit from the person to the grounded floor. A properly grounded ESD wrist or heel strap provides a means to drain the accumulated charge, allowing an operator to remain at the same electrical potential as the ESD-sensitive hardware being handled. These straps are high-resistance grounds in order to protect the person in case of an electrical shock from any of the equipment. ESD safety equipment can also be used to protect the person from harm, such as in high explosive environments like grain elevators filled with flammable dust or in sewage lift stations filled with methane gas. One spark and there's a big problem. When it comes to very high electrical fields, like those in electrical substations, other methods are employed. As always, if you'd like help with your grounding issues or anything related to power, please give us a call. We're here to help. Thanks for watching.